I have somebody really cool coming up to talk to you about this topic that we've been going very deep in today, cybersecurity. Now today we have Dirk Backofen here. He's the head of Telekom Security T-Systems. And he is responsible to build tools for T-Systems themselves and for external clients for cybersecurity. Now, he's been in a top management position for years at Telekom, and today he's going to tell you about a very long word, which I'm going to read out for you, which is Europe's largest integrated cyber defense and security operations center. Now, please put your hands together for Dirk Backofen.
Hey,
thank
thanks.
You. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. Where's the clicker? Hey, where's the clicker, Thorsten? The clicker? They have kicked me out. The clicker is not here. Yeah. A warm welcome from my side as well. I'm really pleased about that you're all attending now this story to hear about what Deutsche Telekom, Telekom Security, is doing about cybersecurity and what we are doing when we are speaking about the European largest integrated cyber defense and security operations center. So therefore, I would like to start a little bit with the first slide, and I hopefully can get the clicker now. Team, could we get the clicker here on stage without having this? Okay. You click it for me, okay, although I click it in this way, if this is working better. I think there's no doubt about yet. I've heard it, there's no clicker here, sorry. You have heard it already during the afternoon and all the presentations that digitization takes place. There's no doubt about. And digitization without cybersecurity, that is really a no-go. So therefore, the question is, in what kind of world we are living in? And as you see, we have all generated, and we especially as Deutsche Telekom, and we are well known as a telecommunication provider, we have generated a world, thank you very much, generated a world in which everything is connected. Everything connectivity is there. And we don't speak about human beings, as you can see here. For 2020, it's expected to have 7.7 billion people on this planet. But the bigger figure is the 50 billion number about the connected devices, because each device which will consume any kind of a battery consumption, they will be connected, they will get an IP address, and so we have a really everything connectivity for everything, also for Internet of Things devices. And that needs, for sure, now in everything security as well. This is exactly the task for the future about we have to speak all together. And then we were very often asked as Deutsche Telekom, when such kind of attacks are taking place, and I can tell you that the number of attacks is really increasing. They are real, and they are really increasing. Then we are asked very often, okay, how many attacks do you see and can you detect every working day? And those figures, as you can see here, are only from 24 hours. And on average, we see on our network infrastructure and on our honeypot infrastructure that we have installed around the world, 12 million attacks per day in average, and maximum already 15 million attacks in one working day. That's the situation in which we are living in. We are gathering and managing every day 2.5 billion security relevant events out of 3,000 data sources every day. This situation, you can't manage this for sure with human beings alone. This is something that you have heard with Mark already beforehand, that you have to do with machine learning and also with some kind of artificial intelligence for sure. This is the situation. And this kind of attacks that we are detecting every day helps us for sure to be protected better and better. Why? Because if you take the 12 million attacks, then for sure more than 11.9 million attacks per day, we know every kind of attack pattern which we are seeing there. But every day, we have 3 up to 8 new attack patterns that we have never seen before. We take them out, put them into the forensic, analyze them, and then create out of those kind of patterns a kind of new structure, how we can strengthen our original systems, our data centers, everything around the globe, which we are responsible for with Deutsche Telekom. This helps us to strengthen our technology and our network for our customers, for our 160 million customers worldwide. And by the way, in parallel, it has helped us together, one of the world's largest library about viruses, zero-day exploits, advanced resistance threats, and so on. As you can see here, 20 million malicious code entries, and only the parental codes, no mutations, only the parental codes. And by the way, in this library is a lot of more stuff in that all the suppliers, all the vendors about cybersecurity have never seen beforehand. Why? Because we are creating and compiling our own viruses, our own zero-day exploits, and also our own APTs. But not to provide and deploy this into the world into, we are doing this to check the technology of all our suppliers. Because how we can be sure that the technology that we are using as Deutsche Telekom is really able to detect some unknown attacks, some kind of unknown threats. And this is something that we exactly do with such kind of library that you are seeing here below. This leads us a little bit to a situation that for sure we as Deutsche Telekom have experienced a lot about cybersecurity in the last 20 years. And we are really proud about that we were never breached in the core systems as such. But it's not only our own task to protect ourselves with our 160 million customers. Our task is to open this knowledge and share this with everybody. You know that our slogan of Deutsche Telekom is life is for sharing. And we can adapt this easily to security is for sharing as well. Therefore, we have established on the 1st of January last year a new business unit, which is named Telecom Security. I'm running this business unit, and we are already 1,400 security experts. 500 of them protecting our critical infrastructure for 160 million customers around the globe. And all the other 900 colleagues, they are doing the same stuff with the same highly professional tools in the same manner for our external market. And in those cases, not only for enterprise customers, for sure also for the German mid-market and also for consumers. This is exactly when we are saying we would like to be the cybersecurity protection shield for all our customers. This is exactly the intention why we have started this and why we have created such kind of a new business unit. And for sure, we are not offering something. We are offering only the same high professional tools with which we are protecting ourselves. This is exactly the story. And yes, for sure, we are proud about to be a really good operator and really good managed security service provider. But also we are not able to offer a 100% cybersecurity to somebody of you. Nobody is able to do this. And therefore, we turn the pyramid around a little bit and say, okay, what is our objection? What is our purpose for activity? And this is for sure to minimize the effect of attacks because the attacks as such, we can't prevent. But the outcome of an attack should be minimized close to zero, and therefore our strategy is here, zero impact. This is exactly what we are doing for us and for our customers. And we are very proud about to say, okay, in the first year of operation, we already achieved the market leadership in Germany with telecom security, €250 million revenue, number one in Germany, number four already in Europe. But our objective is clear, we would like to be number one in Europe as well. And then we were very often asked by our customers, okay, what kind of technology you are using to protect yourself and what are you offering to your customers? And as you can see, it's not only four or five different technologies that we are using here. It's needed to have 40 up to 50 different technology pieces to put all them around the 360-degree circle with those most innovative technology to be protected against all kind of attacks. And normally, each company has to invest into cybersecurity around about 5 up to 6% of the yearly budget on IT. Then you are, in average, really good protected. 5 up to 6% of your yearly OPEX and CAPEX budget in IT. This is the average value. And what kind of technology we are using, you see on the left-hand side, all our partners, which we are providing to our customers. With a clear structure, this is shown with the Magenta Security House in the middle. We as Deutsche Telekom, we invest more. We have in percentage up to 10 up to 11% out of our IT budget. That means 250 million on top to the external revenue, which we are investing into the cybersecurity of Deutsche Telekom every year to protect our 160 million customers. What kind of key questions about cybersecurity have to be answered? And I would like to mention here 6 points before I come to this dedicated topic of integrated cyber defense and security operations center. First of all, when you start the discussion about cybersecurity, then it's not only about having a security by design at the beginning. It's needed after you have launched some kind of services, some kind of products, every week vulnerability scans, and also quarterly per year some kind of penetration test. Because without having this, the single piece of a small adaption in the IT, a single patch, could destroy every kind of the security that you have installed because you have never seen before what kind of circumstances are really existing when you change something in the IT and you have not checked this afterwards regarding the cybersecurity. Some kind of backdoors could be opened. Therefore, penetration tests and vulnerability scanning, this is really a key topic here for everybody. Next one. DDoS protection, distributed denial of services. I think everybody of you is aware about some kind of volume attacks, which are going down to your landing pages, to your web shops, and so on. And in the past, we had seen quite a lot of those things in a range of a gigabit area, 100 gigabit, 200 gigabit. But it's not true anymore. What we currently see is already terabit attacks. At the end of February, we had seen first time 1.3 terabit per second in Europe. Not in Germany, this is a good stuff, but it's already in Europe. 1.3 terabit. And therefore, it's needed to have technology on which you can really clean the traffic in a manner that you have a backbone which is able to protect you until to 2 terabit or something like this on a DDoS protection. This one you can't do on-prem. This one you have to do with some kind of a network partner which has a capacity in the backbone in a range between 80 up to 19 terabit per second. Because only with this kind of 40 times higher capacity, you have a chance to clean the traffic, wash this traffic in a manner that you can say, okay, what are the good bits, what are the bad bits? This is exactly technology we are using here in this kind of stuff. If you come to the third point, then you see this critical stuff about advanced resistant threats. And you have heard also during the afternoon quite a lot about those attacks when you're getting some kind of a file and somebody is clicking on it. And normally an HR department is getting a lot of applications, normally a PDF file. And a lot of people thinking, okay, PDF, it's not executable code, I can click on it. But it's not true. You can only with the opening of a PDF file, you can start a command to download some kind of malicious code from a command and control center. Therefore, it's needed to check all of those files beforehand in a sandbox when you have never seen those file structure beforehand. And the funny stuff is that it's not only needed for mail to have such kind of an APT protection, it's also needed for web. This is exactly the task. And a lot of people saying every time, okay, why it's needed? Because I have installed a firewall, an intrusion prevention system, I have a mail proxy, I have every kind of traditional technology in security. Yes, it's good to have them. But the problem is that they are only looking regarding the known pattern of attacks. APT protection is exactly doing the opposite. Looking into what kind of technology you have to use exactly to look for those things that you have never seen before as an attack pattern. This is exactly the story here with our partners, as you had seen on the slide. If you look onto this picture, then you are going into the area of mobile security into. Why? Because a lot of people are only looking and focusing onto the landline security, data center, everything like this. But what we are doing is for sure also to recommend to have the same level of security for mobile devices, for smartphones, for pets as well. Because an attacker could easily use your phone and can manipulate this to come into your company network into, because they are not looking for your photos or for your chats on a private base. They are looking for exactly those informations with which they could get access to your company network. This is exactly the story here. And please take the simple access in a Wi-Fi. If you would like to go to a hotel and they would like to show an SSID like hotel, who is telling you that this is really the SSID of the hotel and not maybe a faked SSID which will be provided by somebody which is sitting in the neighbor room and then you have getting a man-in-the-middle attack? This is exactly something which is taking place every day. And therefore, it's needed to have some kind of technology like this Mobile Protect Pro that you are seeing here on the left side. The middle pillar we explain a little bit more detailed in the remaining part of the presentation. And last but not least, the sixth element in this discussion on which we have to focus on is for sure the production plans. Because a lot of production facilities in Germany currently are not protected very well. If we have to guess about the security level in Germany, we would like to say that 90% of the corporate networks in Germany are quite well protected. But on the industrial side, industrial production plants, we only see around about 10% of them protected in a really good manner. Why? Because in the past, they have all run their kind of operation in a manner of isolated networks. But this is not true anymore, because with the first robot, with the first Kuga robot or whatever, which you have installed, you have understood that they have to have, for sure, some kind of internet connectivity, because otherwise they have no chance for predictive maintenance, no chance for their kind of a technology regarding getting the new data out of cloud for production, and so on and so on. This is exactly the situation which we are living in. Therefore, clear tasks. Don't forget the industrial the control system security. All the very important when we are speaking about cybersecurity at all. This leads me to the last big chapter of my presentation. A lot of people have focused in the past only onto the prevention. They have installed quite a lot of technology to protect the perimeter level outside of the company, some kind of additional perimeter levels in between that you have some kind of circles around your key assets like your data center or whatever. But this is not true anymore and not good enough anymore. Why? Because you have to anticipate that the attacker is already in your network in. Because how easy it is that somebody is taking a small USB stick and bringing this into the company, putting this into the PC or laptop into, and then you're already attacked if there is no protection installed. Therefore, it's every time needed to have detection as well. And detection and response to be prepared for all those stuff in a manner that you have all the clear outlined runbooks beforehand, before something has happened. This is exactly the task on which all our customers have to look for. And if you look into this picture into, then you see what kind of a toolkit, what kind of pieces are have to be installed in each company that you have really a more or less perfect cybersecurity protection in place. And especially when it comes to the middle pillar and to the right pillar, then you see there are a lot of things in with threat intelligence, with advanced persistent threat protection, IT forensic, and so on which the most of our customers are not able to deal with. Why? Because they are not getting the right experts, they are not getting the right expertise, and they can't follow the speed and the complexities that we are seeing here in this kind of an development in the cybersecurity market. Therefore, we have a huge demand regarding such kind of services, for sure, in a 24/7 approach from all our customers. And based on this big demand, we have decided to create a really huge, new, modern, and innovative integrated cyber defense and security operations center, which is based in Bonn, in our headquarter of Telekom Security. And it's not only Bonn which we have installed there. You should understand this, and I will show you in a second how does it look like. You see it already here a little bit on the picture. I have a movie with me. The situation is that in Bonn, we generate some kind of a magenta heartbeat and control all the satellite security operation centers that we have in Europe, in Germany, in Bad Kreuznach, in Darmstadt, in Kiel, in Leipzig, also in the Czech Republic, in Prague, in Hungary, in Budapest, in Spain, Madrid, and also Cape Town, South Africa. It's all part of the story and will be controlled and steered out of the central part of this huge cyber defense and security operation center. What does it mean really and how does it look like? I would like to present you now in a short movie. Please, the movie.
Cyber attacks. Unfortunately, they're real, and their frequency and ferocity are increasing all the time. In order to make these attacks even more manageable for itself and its customers, Deutsche Telekom in Bonn operates one of the biggest and most modern centers of defense in Europe. Telekom Security's cybersecurity specialists analyze and process more than a billion safety-relevant data from 3,000 data sources every day in a procedure that's almost fully automated. This is also necessary because within a single working day, Telekom records an average of 6 million attacks on its infrastructure around the world. With the opening of Europe's biggest cyber defense and security operations center, Telekom Security is setting new standards in security-related matters. In the process, the highly professional tools used for its managed customer solutions are the same as those with which Telekom protects itself. The whole process has a clear objective: zero impact, which means that nobody should suffer any effects from the cyber attacks. In round-the-clock operations, more than 200 cybersecurity professionals monitor the systems of Telekom and its customers. They recognize cyber attacks, analyze attacking tools, and repel attacks. Security at its best. In providing this service, the Telekom Security headquarters in Bonn also manages the operations at the other security operation centers, which are spread all over Europe and as far afield as South Africa. The most important asset in this job is knowledge of the attack vectors and how one can combat these efficiently. For every large-scale and medium-sized customer that's looked after here, there are individual runbooks that regulate clearly what has to be done when attack indicators appear, 24 hours a day. Together with numerous partners, Telekom Security would like to build an army of the good guys in due course and put hackers in their place. And the best thing about it is that with every new customer, this army of the good guys will grow larger and it will be less difficult to stop attackers. If an attack is detected on a customer's premises, the Cyber Defense Center is activated immediately and protective measures are initiated, not only for the affected customers themselves, but also in preventive fashion for all other customers. Large-scale, medium-sized, and private customers, Telecom Security now offers far-reaching protection from which everyone benefits. In this way, life is for sharing also becomes security is for sharing. Cyber Defense and IT Security. With its integrated Cyber Defense and Security Operations Center, Telecom underscores it once again. Security is Magenta.
So, now you have seen a little bit how does it work in practical. And I would like to explain you a little bit why it's the European largest integrated cyber defense and security operations center. And therefore, I would like to show you this picture. Normally, we are not allowed to show the logos from our customers, but there is one customer which has given us the allowance for that. This is Linde, currently in the merger with Praxair, one of our customers which we are treating in this Integrated Cyber Defense and Security Operations Center. And currently, we are running more than 30 customers there, 15 German DAX companies, and 70 large mid-market customers. And the good stuff is, this is first time that we put our external customers with Deutsche Telekom itself, with more than 160 million customers that we are treating with our network technology into one integrated cyber defense and security operations center into. This allows us a really new kind of story regarding the attack surface, regarding the Counter-Strike methods that we have placed here. And therefore, you see that we have a lot of technology, for sure, and therefore I'm very happy that Mark von Sattelhoff has shown this in the cooperation with IBM as well, that we are using the technology Curator for sure. We have IBM Resilient in our operation, and a lot of other technology. But the technology is, at the end, not the most important stuff. It is more about the knowledge how you have to configure those systems for security incident and event management. Because first, from the beginning, if you would like to install technology, and you have not the right partner on your fingertip, then you have a problem, because then you will be flooded with million, with billion of events per second. Therefore, it's needed to have such kind of so-called use cases, the right settings for all the best filter technology, for the best autocorrelation of all the stuff out of different industries, out of automotive, chemical industry, banking sector, telecommunication for sure with Telecom as well, and to have this in a really integrated manner. This is exactly what makes the difference here in the discussion. And for sure, our customers are asking us every time, okay, how does it work really? And there is for sure a Chinese wall between all of those customer tenants. There is not going any kind of customer data from one tenant to the other. This is clear, some kind of hygiene that you have to have. But the other stuff, and this comes from the bottom, is exactly what we are sharing. We don't share customer data, but we share knowledge. We share all our knowledge about how we have to handle attacks and indicator of compromises. When you have found out in a kill chain whether an indicator of compromise is really going to be an incident, then we have to activate the runbooks. And Mark has explained beforehand why runbooks are needed. And we have for each of our customers different runbooks with different SLAs. And we have to manage them. But the good stuff is maybe the customer number two is attacked. Then we activate for sure the runbook for customer number two. But at the same time, we activate the runbook for the customer number 1, 3, and all the other customers, and for Deutsche Telekom as well, without seeing the attack as such. But we are protecting them in advance. And now you can imagine how does it work. If we put next customer onto, with each new customer, the already existing customers will be protected better and better. We have created some kind of a self-learning system, some kind of a self-learning methodology with which we can protect our customers in a really good way, because we are creating the army of the good guys. Because the army of the attackers are already outside there. But where is the army of the protectors? Where is the army of the good guys which is doing this? All the customers, all the managed security service providers, all the suppliers which are helping us to set something against such kind of attacks in the world into. And to give you some kind of impression about, only briefly, I would like to show you what we are doing really in such kind of a security operation. Looking into a different kind of a pod methodology in our honeypot technology. And by the way, there are some kind of an information which is needed to be known as well. In the past, everybody thought that voice over IP is not attackable. It's not true. We are seeing currently quite a lot of attacks regarding the port 5038. And that means voice over IP is also under attack. This one we can see here in such kind of a technology. Mobile Protect Pro, I have already mentioned. What kind of technology is able to protect every kind of an APT attack on a smartphone, on a pet, in the future? I can give you the promise. This kind of technology is able to detect everything. Why? Because we have put more than 1,000 different vectors onto this device, onto which is correlating all those kind of vectors in a manner that if at the end occurs any kind of an attack vector and some kind of a correlation of those vectors in a manner that you have never seen before, then the device will be shut down and the access to your network as well, because this is combined with a mobile device management. This is exactly the story that you can do here. Then we are looking for our customer every time into the internet and also into the darknet and looking, okay, what kind of hacked accounts we can find. And with credential leakage monitoring, we see every day quite a lot of hacked accounts, leaked accounts, and then we're helping our customers to identify those accounts, checking whether those employees are still in the company and changing for sure all the credentials that they are protected, some kind of additional service and security operation. Then we are doing something on the social media side. Maybe some of you are saying, okay, what social media is related to cybersecurity? Guys, you have no clue about how many attackers are really proud about and they are pre-announcing their attack 5 minutes before the attack is taking place. Exactly in the case of DDoS attacks. We had seen this in the last year quite often. A lot of German DAX companies were attacked, and exactly those attackers, they have used the technology of pre-announcing this. And we are seeing this in a, detecting all Twitter feeds and looking, okay, is there any kind of an information which is correlated with some kind of keywords regarding cybersecurity? This is what we are doing. Then for sure, APT story. And as you can see here, the number 21 in the middle of this circle, this is, by the way, FireEye technology, shows that at this point of time, when we made this snapshot, 21 devices without 225,000 of Deutsche Telekom were at this point of time compromised. Means somebody has put in a USB stick or something into it. That means we have to anticipate that the attacker is already in the network. And normally our colleagues are getting some kind of a call of our cyber security emergency response team, and then they are saying what they have to do. Don't switch off the device. You have to put them into the forensic to understand, to learn what has happened. This is something that we are doing here with our for our customers. For sure, DDoS. We have spoken about this, and you see on this slide and the peaks, this is the maximum DDoS level that we are seeing every day, and it's up to 60 gigabit per second currently. Hopefully those customers have a contract with Deutsche Telekom, because we have a problem. We have a network neutrality. That means we have to deliver all the traffic to our customers, like the postman has to deliver every kind of a letter to you, independently whether there's a bomb in or not. The same one we have to do. We have to bring all the traffic, the good and also the bad, to the customer. DDoS protection helps you until to the terabit range, as I explained, to be protected here. This is a very really effective tool. It's black hole monitoring. This is what we are doing as well. Maybe you have never heard about what black hole monitoring is standing for. We don't looking into the outer space or something like this, looking into the stars. Forget it at all. We are knowing as Deutsche Telekom alone what kind of IP addresses we are using. There was an IP address range assigned to Deutsche Telekom, for sure. But there's in between a range, or more of than one range, a lot of ranges, in which there's no customer on. And normally, if you have IP addresses where there's no connection to a customer, you should expect that there's no traffic. Please look onto the slide here on the left side in green and in the red. There's a lot of traffic on. Why? Because robots, they are giving a shit on what kind of IP address they would like to reach out. They are starting with the first IP address, increase to the next, to the next, to the next. And so they are coming into this kind of a black hole area into. And though we have a really good filter here to see communication of robots out of Mirai botnets or whatever within our cybersecurity operations center, we can detect this. By the way, in this kind of operation, we had seen short before Christmas how the Mirai botnet tried to acquire some kind of Huawei routers into this Mirai botnet into. We have detected this, analyzed this, and we have informed and alerted the entire world, each kind of the supplier, each kind of a technology part of Deutsche Telekom, that we can stop this. This is exactly something that we can do out of Bonn as well. And last but not least, you have a lot of circles around your biggest asset, your customer data. And this is the last element that we are using, last line of defense, on which you detect everything, every big amount of data that you would like to copy, that you would like to get access to. This is blocked automatically by security as well. The good stuff is, normally it's not an attacker or something. Normally it's an IT system, which is maybe not programmed right or whatever. This is something that's also part of the game for cybersecurity operation. And last but not least, this one. Fraudulent domain monitoring. We are, as Deutsche Telekom, one of the biggest operator for DNS, for the main name server farms in the world. The European biggest, by the way, as well. And we have to handle more than 4 billion access points, 4 billion queries regarding DNS entries per day. 4 billion. And we are seeing each day more than 200,000 new entries for DNS names. And as you can see here, what we are doing fully automated is to check whether such kind of names were created by human beings, or it's only created maybe by a robot. Because you see here in the bottom line, there is in a blue color shown some kind of a suspicious domain, which is normally can't be anything that a human being would use. This one we can automatically block, so we can help all our customers that when they are going to be served into the internet, or they would like to be connected to maybe a malicious command and control server, that those kind of IP addresses are blocked. This is part of our operation as well. The key takeaways that you have to take here from this session today. When we are speaking about the European largest cyber defense security operation center, then it's at the end not only about the square meter, the number of people which are working there, it's more about the knowledge. How many different technologies, how many different industrial sectors you can gather with such kind of technology, what kind of experiences, different runbooks and use cases you have. This is exactly the USP, the differentiation point on which we can work, and this is exactly how Deutsche Telekom would like to offer this and open the knowledge that we have about cybersecurity for our external market, for our external customers as well. And this is for sure to be created the army of the good guys. This is our story. And to compile this into one last mission, I would like to suggest here some kind of an 8-point program, top-line program about cybersecurity for the future. Because only when you will be followed on those kind of 8 points, then you have a chance to be protected in the right manner. And as you can see here, we speak about security by design, first from the beginning, in the product development, very important. Vulnerability scanning, I have mentioned. Every week, penetration test every quarter, a quarter in the year. Business mail and also web access from business accounts have to be protected against APT. This is the third demand, as you can see here. DDoS protection in a terabit range. Mobile security has to become mandatory, really mandatory. Currently, it's really one of the untapped areas in the discussions here in Germany. And for sure, every customer has to have some kind of a security operation to go into this area of detection and response into as well, as I have explained on this example of telecom security in the last minutes. And don't forget the industrial control system security. Therefore, maybe one way to accelerate the discussion here, to speed up, is to define such kind of an industrial network technology as critical infrastructure. Because when you are assigned to be in critical infrastructure, then you have to spend more, as you have understood. Not 5 up to 6%, you have to spend 10 up to 11% from your IT budget into those kind of security operations into. Maybe it's a helping hand, also from the German government, to go into this journey onto. And last but not least, we have heard quite a lot during the afternoon about WannaCry and all those other stuff. It's actually, it's regarding speed. WannaCry, 220,000 companies in 50 countries were attacked in only 7 hours. 7 hours. How fast we were able to react? This is exactly the question. And therefore, it's needed to have some kind of methodology how you can be protected really fast, to push some button, then you can load some kind of protect patterns into the technology. This is something on which we are working on, and hopefully we can present you next time here on CeBIT, on the Cybersecurity Summit, some kind of those new technologies, especially regarding the point number 8. I would like to say thank you for your attention. Hopefully, I have given you some kind of impressions about what we are doing regarding cybersecurity for ourselves and also for our external customers. And hopefully, you have understood what is really the USP, the advantage to create such kind of a methodology about a self-learning system, self-improving system regarding threat intelligence and cybersecurity with our integrated cyber defense and security operations center. Thank you very much for your attention.